Today I'm going to teach you the most effective way to stretch your hamstrings with your massage gun. So welcome to my channel. If this is your first time here and you want to learn more fitness tips like this one and also other fitness content like workouts and product reviews, please hit the subscribe button and also hit the notification bell so you get a pop-up every time I launch a new video. So for today's technique, you're going to need two things. Obviously, you're going to need your massage gun, and today I'm actually using the hydro gun. We're going to need the massage gun with the flat shape head first, and then we're going to need it with the fork shape head, which is this one, and you are also going to need a loop band. Now the loop band that I'm using today is a medium tension loop band. I don't actually know the pounds of force. I categorize them more by light, medium, and strong. This is a medium, which is a purple. Depending on the brand, they will change the color, so you will look for a medium brand. If you were you're a more heavier or stronger individual and you feel that the medium band isn't enough for you, can always go back to a stronger band to do it, but by right, usually a medium band will be more than enough. So for today's setup, you're going to need a really strong or heavy fixed point to loop your band. So I have a weight rack here. This is a very heavy duty weight rack, and I've got a set of dumbbells here that go all the way to 20 kg. So the moment I loop the band down there at one of the anchor points, if I pull the band, you can see that the rack doesn't move. So it needs to be a fixed point. You can't do this on the table. You can't do this on the stool, because the moment you loop the band around one of those surfaces, the moment you stretch the band, the table or the stool are going to move. So it has to be a heavy duty equipment. So at your gym, you won't have shortage of options or where you can loop the band. If you're doing this at home, if you happen to have a weight rack like I do, loop it there. If not, grab the heaviest pair of dumbbells or kettlebells that you have, loop them there, and then you can actually fix those on the floor, okay? But it has to be heavy ones. It has to be at least 25 to 30 kgs and above. Otherwise, the moment you loop them on those tools, the moment you do this to the band, the anchor point is going to move. So I don't want you to get hurt doing this. So this is a really important detail. It has to be a fixed point. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use the flat shape head. I'm going to do my left leg, and for the sake of time, I'm only going to use one side, and then you will repeat the process on the other leg. What I want to do first is I want to warm up the tissue. I want to get some blood flowing them over there, so improve blood circulation, get the fluids to move around. So I'm going to put this into the highest vibration possible, and now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go up and down around the hamstring area. I will target the hamstrings first. I'm just going to go up and down and allow the vibration to do the work. Really speed gliding up and down. I'm not looking for trigger points, or I'm not looking for those sore spots. I'm really just moving up and down, trying to cover as much surface of the hamstrings as I can. And I'm actually go also into the glute area, because this stretch will pretty much stretch the whole posterior chain. It's not just hamstring focused. It has a really big component on all of the posterior chain, but definitely we will feel it a little bit more on the hamstrings. But I've had people report when I do this stretch with my clients, I've had clients of mine telling me that they actually feel it a lot also on the calf. So what we want to do first is we want to go through the whole posterior chain, even the calves, just improving blood circulation now for a little bit, letting the vibration do its work. And if you spend maybe about 30 seconds to 60 seconds on each area with a high speed of vibration, it won't take long until you feel that it starts to feel warm. So that's exactly what we want to do. We want to spend as much time as we want on both areas, the calves, followed by the hamstrings again, until you feel that they're starting to get warm. So about maybe 90 seconds should be enough. Now that I've done the warm-up stage, I'm gonna go to step number two. So I switch to the fork shape head. And the reason, there's no particular reason why I use the fork shape head. It's more because of the feeling and stabilizing the device while I'm doing the technique. I just feel that the two points of contact on the of the fork really sit well on my hamstrings while I'm doing that this technique, and even on the calves, and I feel that I can stabilize the device much better on that area doing this particular technique. So what I'm going to go is, well, I'm going to loop the band on my leg, on the front part of the leg. So I'm going to move here into a diagonal position over here. So it's right on my upper thigh, as high as I can bring it in. So it's really, really there in the groin area, and as far up on the thigh as I can, on the front. And then your anchor point is behind you. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna put a little bit of tension on that band. I don't need to stretch it too much, just a little bit of tension. I'm gonna lock out this knee, and I'm gonna take a step forward with my opposite leg, which in this case is my right leg, and then I'm just gonna lean forward. So now what I'm trying to do here is, I'm trying to find my balance first. I'm going to adjust my position according to the force of the band so that I can be in a good balanced position. I lock out this knee, really starting to stretch that hamstring already. And now I'm going to forward fold. So what I don't want to do is, I don't want to just curve my spine and trying to reach down there. Yes, I will feel some stretch there on my hamstring, but not as focused and as intense as if I try to keep my back straight and now I just hinge forward. Okay, now I really start to feel that stretching sensation starting to come in. So I'm going to do this step by step. I'm going to go to a comfortable range of motion where I feel that my hamstring starts to stretch. And now what I'm going to do with my opposite hand, I'm going to turn on my device. I'm going to put it into a medium speed. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to look for those points where I feel that the stretch feeling, you know, that painful stretch feeling starts to lock my movement. Meaning if I push further, it would hurt too much, so I wouldn't go there. So in reality, what the device now is doing is it's helping me to tone down those pain receptors on my hamstrings and allowing me to move into a better range and to a more further range of motion when I normally wouldn't if I wouldn't use the device at the same time. So probably if I wasn't using the massage gun, I would stay here, I would lock in, and I couldn't go past this point because it's just too painful to go there. And then we don't want to go to that point because when it becomes too painful, your body locks. So you might feel, oh, I'm grinding, I'm stretching, I'm grinding. But literally what you're doing is you're just pushing against your own body. Your body is locking up, it's feeling painful. You think that you're actually stretching, but you're not. It needs every stretch that you do, you have to always remind yourself of two things. You need to be able to control the position. You need to be able to breathe into that position. And it needs to feel bearable. If it's too painful, your body is fighting against the pain and then it defeats the purpose of stretching. That's where these devices become really helpful. Because when I get to that point where I start to feel that the pain is too much, I scan the tissue where that pain feels a little bit more unbearable. I give it a little bit of stimulus with the percussion, and guess what? That painful feeling starts to dissipate. It doesn't completely go away, but it dissipates. So now, if you watch, I'm going to spend here a couple of seconds. I'm in this 90 degree or almost 90 degree position. I actually feel that I can go a bit further. So I'm actually going to take a step forward with my opposite leg to sink in better into that position. And now I'm just going to try to get in there. So I feel that I can go a little bit extra range. Again, I'm looking to where those points of tension start to build up. And guess what? I feel that I can go a bit further. So here you go. I lean forward. I try to keep that good neutral position of the spine. You might see a little bit of a curve on my lower back, which is totally fine. I'm keeping truthful to that intention of keeping my hips stable and my lower back flat So if you do lose a little bit of the neutrality of the position, it's fine, as long as you're not completely curved like this. As long as you're actively trying to push the hip forward, locking that back knee, reaching further as far as you can. And guess what? As I continue to do this and I rub up and down with the massage gun, that percussion allows me to tolerate this position a little bit more, so I can spend a few extra seconds here without crying from pain. And it allows me to start to regain some of that range of motion that I lose from sitting down the whole day or being inactive the whole day. Or maybe I just did a really heavy deadlift session yesterday and my hamstrings feel cooked. So I spend a little bit of time here creating a length in that structure that often doesn't see the light of day because we spend too much time inactive or sitting down. After you've done the other leg, you repeat the same process on the opposite leg. Remember to start the warm-up session with the flat shape. You have to really just get some warm-up into the muscle tissue, get the blood flowing, get some blood flowing in there, making all those fluids moving around, getting the tissue ready for the work that you're about to do. Then you go into the loop pan and you do it. As usual, remember to stay in a good, comfortable range of motion. Respect the limits of your own body. Don't try to push too far. If it feels too painful, it's because it's probably already too much. So always stay within a comfortable range of motion. Remember that the more you move, the better you get at it. In the meantime, take a look at this playlist over here that has all the techniques that I've been posted on this channel since I started doing these videos. And also take a look at this playlist here that has other product reviews of other massage guns and tools that might be useful to your fitness lifestyle. Until then, I will see you on the next video.